Blackstone presents New Dragon City by Mary Mancusi. This book is read by Alex Boyles and Soneela Nankani. To Diana, Mother of Dragons and Best of Friends. Chapter 1.
The library? Again? Really?
Maya raised her eyebrows at me as we stepped out of an old hotel and onto the sidewalk of what used to be known as Times Square. The sun was shining high in the sky, and the air was warm and sweet, with only a hint of ash to it thanks to a light breeze. A perfect April New York City day. I slung my empty backpack over my shoulder, then leapt onto a cracked cement barricade, jumping off the other side. What can I say? I gave her a devilish grin. I'm out of books again.
Of course you are,
she groaned, dodging a parked car with a smashed windshield as we abandoned the sidewalk to head down 42nd Street. Maya always liked to tease me about my obsession with reading and my superpower of finishing books at lightning speed. But I knew, deep down, she didn't really mind our frequent trips to the New York Public Library. For one thing, it was a super cool building, with huge marble lions standing guard outside and endless stacks of books once you walked in, just waiting to be borrowed. Maya liked books too, even if she didn't have much time for reading, after putting in long hours helping out with her family's shop. Her mother had one golden rule: work first, play second, and that included reading. My mother, on the other hand, had been a teacher back in before times and always made reading a priority. In fact, she'd built a tiny library filled with our favorite books down in our family bunker when we'd first gone underground 5 years ago. When we had left the bunker 3 years later, there were still books I hadn't gotten a chance to read yet. Mom had wanted to take some of them along with us, but Dad insisted we save the room in our packs for more essential supplies like food and water. Which made sense, of course. My dad was always the practical one. But I knew it had made Mom sad to leave her precious collection behind, to know they would remain there forever, gathering dust, unread.
Fine, we'll hit the library, Maya agreed.
Then she wagged her finger at me.
But seriously, Noah, no more than 3 books. The last time we went, you picked out so many books you had no room left in your pack for actual supplies.
As if you didn't fill half your pack with chocolate that day, I shot back with an impish grin. She rolled her eyes.
It was Valentine's Day. We needed it for the shop.
For the shop, right. I gave her a teasing look. And you wouldn't dream of eating any of it yourself now, would you? She shoved me playfully. I scurried away, dancing down the empty 42nd Street, my steps light as I leapt over piles of trash and other debris. It really was a beautiful day out. Great scavenging weather. Maya and I were gatherers, along with some of the other kids in our group. We'd go out into the city and search for stuff like canned food and batteries and medicines and other non-perishable items and bring them back to our home base to barter with. It was kind of like a treasure hunt. You never knew what you might find abandoned from the world before. One time, I found this amazing limited edition Zelda figurine in an old comic book store. The box said there had only been 100 made, which meant it had probably been worth a ton once upon a time. But now it was free for the taking. Mom had never liked me scavenging. She worried it could be dangerous. You never knew if a floor had become unstable, rotted away over the years.
You'll break your leg, she'd say, and who will fix it if you do?
After all, while there were still hospital buildings, there were no doctors left to run them. And while there was still medicine, much of it was years past its expiration date, which meant something as simple as a scratch from a rusted piece of metal could be a death sentence, something Mom used to love to remind me of. But Mom was gone now, and Dad didn't worry about silly things like
screech.
A sudden shrieking sound tore through the air, stopping me dead in my tracks. My eyes snapped to Maya beside me to see if she'd heard it too. She stood still as a statue, her brown face lifted to the sky, her eyes wide and searching. My heart skittered in my chest.
Was that? Could it be?
I swallowed hard, trying to will my hands to stop shaking, all thoughts of books and bright spring days vanishing in an instant as my mind raced with panic and fear.
It couldn't be, right? There was no way.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.